How's it going, everyone? College Lefty, and in this video, I'm going to be debuting the 97 overall Fergie Jenkins and the 96 overall Ryan Braun that was just released into MLB The Show today. So let's go ahead and get right into it. This is also going to be my first game on Legend in ranked season, so I'm a little bit excited. I also kind of want to see, you know, how the game is going to play, especially using, you know, a couple of brand new players for the first time. But with that being said, this Fergie Jenkins looks very good. He could actually be one of the better right-handed pitchers that we have in the game. Of course, there's Edward Cabrera and Quinn Priester, but I would expect to see a lot of these kitchen sink players on people's teams because they're going for, you know, a good amount of stubs on the market, but also for good value. These are great players, 96 overalls, 97 overalls for about 60,000 stubs. That's pretty solid. And I'm going to be using this Ryan Braun card in left field, but this opponent also has Ryan Braun and Fergie Jenkins, so pretty solid team as well. A couple budget players in there, as well as a couple of those player of the month cards. So that's nice. But here we go. First game on Legend. We have the World Series gold banner around the scoreboard. I think it looks pretty cool. We have Fergie Jenkins on the mound trying to get an early confidence boost on some of these fastballs. Fastball, sinker. I'm really looking to mix in this forkball. That was pretty easy to use right there. Forkball low in the zone. We get the strikeout. Hopefully, you know, I'm able to put up a little bit of run support in this game. I don't know how this timing window is going to be playing, you know, first game on Legend difficulty. But with that being said, 1-2-3 first inning from Fergie Jenkins. Pretty solid pitcher so far. Let's see what we can do at the plate. I looked absolutely horrendous. I had a couple strikeouts and I got jammed with Alfonso Soriano. But this opponent bloops one in here with Ryan Braun. Good start for him with that card. Looks to be okay versus righties. He's laying down a sacrifice bunt. This is, you know, pretty good strategy. Leadoff guy gets on base. You want to try and move him over. A bunt is better than a strikeout. Now we got to face Marcus Semien going with a sinker on the inside corner. That was a little unlucky, right? That was a pretty decent hit, but at the same time, it just barely gets down the line. Semien has a very quick swing. I just was not able to get that inside enough. But we are going to get the double play to get out of the inning. Let's see if we can finally get something going at the plate. We're back on the mound here with Fergie Jenkins. Another poor inning on offense. Lead it off with an extra base hit from the opponent here. This is not a good start. 98 speed on second. I'm using Mike Trout in center field just because I wanted to use that Ryan Braun card in his primary. Here he's going with another bunt. Tried to throw that pitch below the zone. I was expecting a bunt. I had my creative player behind the plate. Might have been able to throw him out, but I'm going to bring the infield in. We bring the infield in, and once again, we get a little unlucky. It's all right. It is what it is. I still think that Fergie Jenkins is a pretty good pitcher. I'm just getting a little unlucky with them. Haven't really given up too many hard hit balls so far. Here we get to strike him out, throw him out. Pablo Sanchez with the cannon for an arm. 99 arm strength, diamond defense, 91 blocking. Great build for a catcher. Also getting the first base hit of the game. Took me about four innings before I could get a base knock with two outs here in the fourth. But now we have Chipper Jones up, coming up to start off the next half of the inning. Starts us off with a very interesting home run. I don't know. PCI wasn't on it. Barrel of the bat looked to be somewhat, you know, the bat path looked to be somewhat on the ball. Hits it out for a home run. I will take it. I've already had a couple perfect outs. I had, you know, a line drive from Chipper Jones in his first at bat right to the first baseman. So I'll take that home run. Here we have Jackie Robinson up, trying to get something going here. Bottom of the sixth inning, 2-1 game. It's low scoring here. I don't know if I'm going to be able to finish it off, so I need to score some runs. Try and get as much gameplay as possible. Fergie Jenkins had a pretty good debut so far. This opponent's also pitching pretty well with Fergie Jenkins. I think he has the potential to be one of the better right-handed pitchers in the game right now. Here we get really unlucky. Forkball, waited on it long enough, barreled it up, squared it up with the PCI, was early out in front of it on the early side of good, just did not get the right launch angle with the creative player. Very next at bat, Jim Thome, he's going deep on a curveball low in the zone. That was probably the one pitch that this opponent was on, was the curveball inside, and then of course the sinker. He had the base hit with Semien, he had the base hit with Tatis, and then that home run with Thome. Those are his best hits of the game so far, and he has three runs. He's been able to get base knocks, little bloops here and there, and of course a little bit lucky as well, but the sacrifice bunts are really the difference in this game so far. Mike Trout goes deep with the home run Here we have one at-bat with Ryan Braun. I know it took me a few minutes, but I had a couple outs with them. I did get a base knock here in the seventh. Unfortunate. I just did not hit that well with runners in scoring position. We have five hits apiece, but that's the difference. Those sacrifice bunts, him getting off to a good start early on in the game, right? Fergie Jenkins gave up two runs so far. I went to Adam Wainwright, and now I'm probably going to go to Mariano Rivera. But I'm facing Rob Dibble. This guy's unbelievable on Legend. And really, this game is just challenging in general on Legend. I mean, it's a lot of fun. I have had a lot of fun playing this, even though I only have, you know, two runs in the top of the ninth. We got to get something going in the bottom of the ninth. We got to get there first, though. We're facing Jim Thome. He already has a homer in the game. We went with the fastball or cutter inside and got him swinging there. So we just need one run to tie it. We just need one run, but it seems like that's going to be tough to get. Here I don't know what I'm doing. Swinging at a pitch I thought was a fastball. That thing was a slider. If it was a fastball, I think I would have missed it entirely. But now we have Mike Trout up. He already has a home run as well. That is an absolute dot of a pitch. 102-mile-per-hour fastball, literally right on the inside corner. But we have Chipper Jones. Chipper Jones will be our last hope here. A 1-1 count. He's smacking one to right field, and that is going to be 3 feet foul. 3 feet to the right of the foul pole. I cannot believe it. Game-tying home run down to the last out, and that's how we're going to end it. We swung at a pitch that probably would have hit him, and we lost there. 3-2. It's all good. That was my first game on Legend. I wasn't really expecting anything crazy or, you know, to put up a crazy amount of runs. I'm glad I was able to finish the full nine-inning game. That is a huge accomplishment in itself. But take a look at this upcoming schedule. We do have some stuff coming out. In the next couple of days here, we have a brand new ranked seasons. Brand new legend coming to the choice pack and also a new event. So I'm excited for that stuff. It will be awesome to see. However, I'll probably start off in like the 700s, I think, for this upcoming ranked seasons because I dropped down into the championship series. I'm not exactly sure how that will work, but this is going to be the squad. I won't necessarily start Ryan Braun all the time, but I think he will have a lot more value on the bench anyway, facing left-handed pitchers. Buxton might not even be as good as him facing righties, but the defense and the speed really helps out. But this is the squad. I'm going to keep Fergie Jenkins. I like Fergie Jenkins. He's pretty good, even though gave up a couple of runs there. I forgot to talk about Juan Marichal in my last video. This is a brand new player program, breakout card. That's probably the best thing about this card is that he is a breakout player because there aren't that many breakouts in comparison to the other sets that we have in the game. But this card might be decent because he has a screwball. I don't think he'll be very good in general, especially on the tougher difficulties against better players. He won't be that usable. But I'm College Lefty. Those are a couple debuts, and peace out.